it's inevitable that Adidam is cultic. It's inevitable. Unless every member, every moment of the day is coming from seventh stage disposition. When they're meeting, when they're doing things with one another, when they're in the puja and the meditation form, it's bound to be cultic. It's bound to be a group of people working together to establish a religion with its various disciplines. It's bound to be cultic. There's no way it cannot be. Clenched fist disposition is inevitable. Only a true devotee who is practicing from the place of hearing and seeing is free of that cultic disposition. But the free man cannot be accepted or acknowledged because the free man is humorous. The free man is forever objectionable, a renegade. The free man isn't attached to the disciplines, isn't attached to establishing a way of life. That's inevitably cultic. The free man cannot be acknowledged, accepted, embraced within the culture of Adidam. It's inevitable that the one who hears, the true devotee, one who sees, belongs nowhere. It's inevitable that he or she will stand alone. Alone is the condition of bliss. That's how it is. No praise or blame. That's exactly how it is. The one who hears, the true devotee, is a fool. The true devotee cannot be tied down within the conditions of the conditional world, including the organization, the establishment of Adidam. Adidam had a vision. It is inevitable that that vision is going to fail if even four people coming together aren't practicing from the feeling of the self-contraction as being their own activity. Satsang, communion, is gracefully given. It's not even deserving. I remember Adidas saying that you don't deserve grace. This can't deserve it. Only grace removes this so that one can have the enjoy the blessings, the intimacy, the happiness that is always already the case. So it's inevitable that Adidam is going to fail, the vision of Adidam. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe right now, overnight, the establishment called Adidam is no longer run or governed by clenched fist dispositions. Do you really think Adidas would be happy if you come along and say to him, look, Master, look at what we've established? I remember James Steinberg commenting to an email that an ex-devotee wrote, and James was very offended by it. And part of his response was, look what we've established. Look what we've done. Look at the greatness of the devotees. Yes, a lot has been established, but it's just another condition. What did Jesus say? No stone will remain as they are upon one another. A true devotee is simply alone, just as Adidas stood alone. The vision that Adidas had is far removed from what has been established. However, in saying that, an establishment is necessary for a true renunciate to live. Is that true? Maybe that's not true either. Renouncing the ego is what a true renunciate is. The outward signs are not it. And the inner signs that the person is aware of is not it necessarily. Jesus said, don't think about tomorrow. Don't think about what you're going to say next. Implying, be spontaneous. Allow God to live you. Have faith and trust that each day will be suffice unto itself. I'm not anti-Adidam. Nor am I pro-Adidam. Adidam is simply what it is. Would there be an orchestra, say 60, 70 members, playing absolutely from the open hand disposition? Is that the case right now? Is there an orchestra? Is there a choir singing totally in this disposition right now? Is it possible to establish a group of people as an open hand? No, because again it's a graceful happening. It's the way of divine grace. What the way of the heart is. I had no expectations of myself, if I remember rightly, when I first became a form of devotee. But there were others having expectations of me. I simply was and is a true devotee. And this body mind, due to that disposition of being a true devotee, has encountered quite a lot of conditional, what would be known and considered to be conditional negativity. Maybe unlawful occurrences. True devotee, as has been written many times, is not concerned about the results of his or her reactions. In that moment, Adidam has been my teacher. He showed me the light that diffuses the darkness. And show me that, revealed to me in this moment, already happiness, already peace, already the feeling of being at home, no matter what. No matter what. Join me in establishing a set of conditions called Adidam 2. No praise, no blame, it's just as it is. It's inevitable that the organization, the institution called Adidam, is cultic. No matter how much Adidam might have said, that he did not want Adidam to be cultic. It can only be not cultic, this disposition. It's just a bit. There we are. Amen. Blessings. Comment, I will miss. No matter what is arising or falling right now, is occurring in consciousness. And if Adidam or if Adidam didn't enlighten anybody then, what was it all about? He said, where the heart begins at seventh stage realization, or seventh stage disposition. So be it.